Hi there, my name is Brian, and on this episode of Heads Up for Hosers, we're going to jump right into what makes up a hydraulic hose. Hose is one of the most overlooked aspects of a hydraulic system, but it's actually one of the most important components in making sure that your system works like a well-oiled machine. The flexibility of hose compared to pipe allows the components to be positioned in the most efficient or convenient places. Let's take a look at what's in a hose and see what it needs to hold up against all of the external and internal forces it faces. Modern hydraulic hose typically consists of three parts: an inner tube that carries the fluid, a reinforcement layer, and a protective outer layer. The inner tube must be compatible with the fluid it's carrying. That is, the tube can't have a chemical reaction to the fluid moving through it. The inner tube must also be able to withstand the temperature of the fluid it's carrying. When your hose is incompatible with the fluid moving through it, it can lead to the breakdown of the tube and even the failure of the hose. That's what makes the material of the hose so important. The first material used to create hoses was natural rubber. But the lack of availability and the incompatibility with several chemicals led to the development of synthetic rubbers. Natural rubber is still used in applications such as construction and tubing for medical devices, but has been phased out mostly within the hydraulic industry. Now, there are several different compounds used in the inner tube, but let's focus on the five most often used in the hydraulic hoses. Nitrile rubber, also called Buna N or NBR, is the most common rubber compound in hose. Nitrile rubber has excellent resistance to oil and other chemicals, which makes it great for carrying petroleum-based products such as diesel fuel and crude oil. Nitrile rubber is also used for conveyor belts and seals in plumbing and appliance applications. Next up is AQP, elastomeric material, AeroQuip's own compound. When AQP was developed, it was necessary to stock a different hose for pure petroleum-based fluids, phosphate ester-based fluids, or a petroleum blend fluid. AQP was designed to be compatible with all three. Compared to the conventional nitrile rubber, AQP has a greater fluid compatibility, a greater temperature range, up to 300 degrees Fahrenheit as a continuous operating temperature, a greater service life, and a better shelf life. AQP is generally used in severe and specialized hydraulic applications and has a blue cover. PTFE, polytetrafluoroethylene, more commonly known as Teflon, is one of the most widespread compounds. You can find PTFE in everything from cookware, nail polish, to windshield wiper blades, and more. But because PTFE is inert, which means it doesn't react with fluids and has a temperature resistance up to 388 degrees Fahrenheit, this is the ideal compound for hose tube in the steam, marine, chemical processing, truck, and bus industries. A downside to PTFE is that it tends to be quite brittle, and a hose with a PTFE tube cannot be bent as tightly as those with other internal compounds. Because of the brittle nature of the PTFE inner tube, it can collapse if it is pinched or twisted. However, 98% of chemicals can be pumped through this tube, making it an ideal material for the chemical processing industry. If you're looking for a hose tough enough to hold up to any weather, look no further than EPDM, or ethylene propylene diene monomer. EPDM rubber is a great choice for outdoor applications due to its resistance to the effects of ozone and temperature. EPDM hoses are commonly used in aircraft ground equipment, water transfer, and septic waste removal, but can also be found in automotive weather stripping, electrical insulation, and garden and appliance hose. Last up is thermoplastic hose. Thermoplastic offers a number of benefits, including the ability to handle extreme temperatures, great abrasion resistance, and the ability to withstand salt water, ozone, UV radiation, and a variety of chemicals. Thermoplastic tube typically has a smooth internal surface that allows for efficient flow and reduces flow loss. It also tends to expand less, even at maximum working pressure. The thermoplastic is used frequently in forklift and sewer flush applications. There are two variants of thermoplastic hose: black for conductive hose and orange for non-conductive hose. As material flows through a hose, molecules collide with each other. During these collisions, some of the electrons are knocked off and create a tiny amount of electrical charge. This charge increases with the length of the hose assembly, the coarseness of the transferred material and the hose's inner tube, and the speed and volume of the material transferred. If an orange non-conductive hose is used, the charge has nowhere to go, so it builds up in the fitting at the delivery end of the hose. If this fitting isn't properly grounded, the charge keeps accumulating until it creates an electrical arc, a spark. Depending on the circumstances and the material you are transporting, that spark might ignite volatile materials near or inside the hose and create a catastrophic event, even electrocution. Orange thermoplastic hoses are non-conductive with an orange cover and no holes in the surface. Non-conductive hoses won't take on water and therefore won't conduct electricity. These hoses are found on lift trucks in case of contact with any overhead wires. Conductive hoses are black and have tiny pinholes in the cover to prevent static electricity buildup and arc discharge. This keeps you and your hose safe. Now we're going to talk about the reinforcement layers. Let's take a closer look. This layer gives your hose the strength and the ability to withstand pressure both internally and externally. The reinforcement layer can be made from textile yarn or metal wire, and it comes in two styles, braided or spiral. The braided reinforcement layer, commonly made from one or two layers of steel or textile yarn, has a higher flexibility and tighter bend radius than that of a spiraled reinforcement layer. It works best in a medium pressure application and is found most commonly in construction equipment, heavy-duty trucks, and fleet vehicles. However, in impulse pressure situations where the amount of pressure running through a hydraulic line can vary in bursts, the braided reinforcement is more likely to cause wear and break in the hose. This is because the braids rub against each other during flexing and eventually weaken and break, causing a failure. Heavy-duty equipment needs something that can handle high impulse pressure, and that's where the spiraled reinforcement comes in. Spiraled reinforcement is made of 4 to 6 layers of steel wire, which don't cross over each other as they do in a braided reinforcement, but remain parallel as they wrap around the hose. This leads to a stronger hose, but becomes harder to bend because the wires don't move as easily within the layers. You'll find spiral reinforcement hose in everything from a ride-on lawnmower to gargantuan earth movers. Finally, the cover of the hose provides protection from the outer environment, including abrasion, heat, corrosion, and environmental deterioration. Hose covers can be made from synthetic rubber, fiber braids, thermoplastic, and AQP. Rubber covers are ideal for abrasion protection, and they don't trap dirt and moisture. Covers made with fiber braids or cloth are preferred when gases are being conveyed through the hose, since the cloth allows the gas to release naturally. In a rubber cover, unless it is pinpricked, the gases would be trapped, causing the cover to blister or force the tube and the cover to separate. See this line of text along the cover? That's the ley line, which provides all the information that we just went through. It has everything you need to know about the hose, including the manufacturer, the production date, maximum operating pressure, part number, size, and industry specification. This ley line can be ink, mylar, or embossed. An embossed ley line will allow you to read the information even if the hose is painted. Now that you got a handle on the inner workings of a hose, you're practically an expert. But hold your hoses, because we've got a lot more to show you on the next episode of Heads Up for Hosers. Again, I'm Brian, and I hope you have a great Canadian day.